I want to propose this phase 3 trial in renal cell carcinoma that just opened. This is Meteor, a phase 3 randomized study of cabozantinib, a dual VEGF-MET inhibitor versus everolimus in subject with metastatic clear cell renal cell carcinoma. As an introduction, this audience know well the role of VEGF and MET in RCC. In fact, VHL gene dysfunction, predominant in clear cell RCC, leads to impaired HIF degradation, which transcriptionally activates not only the VEGF pathway, but also the MET pathway. We know well that activated MET result in invasive RCC phenotype, and we learned from Dr. Gibney and colleagues that higher MET expression in clear cell RCC correlate with worse disease-specific survival and is completely an independent predictor of survival. We also know from a very important work for Cennino et al. That resistance to VEGF pathway target agent can be overcome by inhibition of MET. Cabozantinib is a dual VEGF-MET tyrosine kinase inhibitor that showed preliminary activity as an investigational agent in multiple solid tumor, including renal cell carcinoma, in a work that we presented at the 2012 ASCO meeting. This is the design of the phase 3 Meteor study. This will be an open-label randomized phase 3 study of 200 sites, primarily in North America and Europe. Patient with metastatic renal cell carcinoma, 650, with clear cell histology, measurable disease, and who progressed on prior VEGF tyrosine kinase inhibitor will be randomized 1:1 to cabozantinib at 60 milligram once a day versus everolimus at 10 milligram once a day. It will be again a 1:1 randomization without crossover. The primary endpoint is progression-free survival per independent radiology review, and the secondary endpoint are overall survival and objective response rate. These are the statistics. The primary endpoint is PFS analysis per independent radiology committee. We assume 5 months PFS, 4.9, in fact, on the everolimus trial, the record one. 259 events are required among the first 375 randomized patients. This is designed to have a 90% power to detect a 50% meaningful improvement in median PFS from 5 to 7.5 months, which correspond to a hazard ratio of 0.66. We will have power for a secondary endpoint of OS, assuming 15 months OS on record one trial, with 408 events are required to provide 80% power for a 33% improvement in median OS from 15 to 20 months. There'll be a single interim analysis of OS at the time of the primary PFS analysis. In terms of additional endpoint on the study, the duration of response, the safety and tolerability, pharmacokinetics, and two health-related quality of life with the help of Dr. Sella, the NCCN Functional Assessment of Cancer Therapy, the FACT Kidney Symptom Index Questionnaire, as well as the European Health Questionnaire. We'll look also at skeletal-related event, especially with the data with cabozantinib in prostate cancer, as well as an array of biomarker. In terms of key eligibility criteria, RCC with clear cell component and measurable disease, prior treatment with at least one VEGF targeting TKI, no prior treatment with an mTOR inhibitor. And for the most recently received VEGF TKI, patient need to have progressed during the treatment or treated for at least 4 weeks and progressed within 6 months after the last dose. The last dose must have been within 6 months before randomization. And this trial has no limit on the number of additional anti-cancer therapies. And in fact, it allows patient with brain metastases. And if my voice bored you, you only need to go to the meteorclinicaltrial.com and everything will be there. Thank you very much.